we're here with Mario Paolucci. Mario Paolucci is from GNR in Rome, and he coordinates the Future ICT 2.0 project. Mario, what is your main motivation to be part of this exciting project?
Well, I was in Future ICT since the beginning, seeing it happen, and my main motivation was that these kind of tools are really the tools that we need to help people understand what is happening around them. With all the technological advances and the world changing so fast, we need projects that help us to think in a reflexive way about what we're doing, and I think that Future ICT can provide these kind of tools to people. And then in more detail, this project has a chance to test our skills, which are for building simulations. So starting from behavior of a single individual and seeing how this interacts at a collective level.
That sounds very scientific and kind of far away from what somebody on the street would grasp. If I don't understand all the technical terms and the scientific terms, what is in for me as a citizen?
An example that I've been thinking recently is that all our techniques, which mix simulation, which is the part that I do, with data science, which some other very good people in the project are doing, this mix could help, for example, disentangle the current situation in the job market, because we live in a paradoxical situation in which there's much more job that can be done by machines, but still the humans want more jobs, and so we have high levels of unemployment, which is not desirable, with a high production. Of course, those two things shouldn't go together, but we need the intelligence to find new ways of doing things, and so to help us solve this paradox. And that could be the basis of a project like the future of work. And the future of work is something that obviously concerns every single citizen.
So Future ICT 2.0 runs officially until early 2020, but there are some other projects that can follow or that might even start before. We're looking forward to great collaboration with you. Thank you.